As far as if people are having problems with aggressiveness in their horse, I know each situation is different, but what would be some tips that you could give us regarding that?
Well, it's very simple and it goes back to basics as all training does. You simply need to know there's a hierarchy in the herd and it's linear, which means that each and every individual of the herd is either dominant over or subordinate to each and every other individual. So you and your horse can only act as interact in terms of herd behavior because that's all he knows. And he can only think of you in the herd sense. And so in that herd of two, you have two choices. You are either dominant or you are subordinate. That's the way it has to be. And horses, no matter how docile they are or no matter how dominant they are, in lieu of leadership, the horse will take charge because somebody has to be the leader. And so if your horse does not accept your authority, one thing I see a lot at clinics is that horses that are disdainful of their human and they're and I see all the time people that have been doing groundwork of whatever flavor for a long time, and the horse is doing all the little tricks and jumping through the hoops. But it is with a great deal of disdain and animosity, and it's pulling its ears back, and it's just it's not a cooperative willingness. And but what happens is when people are not acting as leaders all the time, but then they keep trying to assert themselves as leaders, for instance, when they're doing the groundwork. The horse really learns to disdain them because it's like, who do you think you are trying to tell me you're the leader when you so clearly are not the leader because of all these other things you do the rest of the time? And I tell people all the time when I can't see, if I can see them and their interaction face to face, it's all real clear to me. But when it's through an email or, over the phone or something, and I can't see what's going on. I tell people all the time, what you need to do is examine your entire interactions with the horse and figure out where it is that you are eroding your authority because you are somewhere. And, the simplest and clearest example is the people that hand feed treats to their horses. And to the simple thing that people must understand is how is hierarchy established in the herd? And it's very, very simple. There's only two factors involved in establishing.